We all have those days when our skin just won't cooperate. I mean, acne, pimples, oily skin, breakouts, you name it, and my face has it all. I mean, look at this one pimple right here. It is making my nose look like Rudolph the red-nosed deer. I mean, weeks ago, I had crystal clear skin, and now everything has made a comeback because of traveling, pollution, and everything, okay? So, I've decided to try salicylic acid face wash for a week and see if it is really worth the hype, because I've seen so many videos where people are telling, you know, try this face wash for a week and you know your pimples, your acne will reduce, your oily skin will become better and everything. So I really wanted to see if it is worth the hype. So I'm going to document 7 days, okay, of using this product, and I'm going to share the good and bad, and by the end of the week I will decide whether or not it is worth the hype. Now I have taken this face wash from Plum Goodness. There are a lot of other market leaders from which you can purchase. I particularly took foaming face wash because earlier I tried gel based face wash of salicylic acid, and that legit made my face dry and very tight and everything, so I didn't have a good experience with that. So I'm gonna try this out, okay? So first, before actually documenting my journey, I'm gonna do a patch test. I'm gonna just take a few pumps and test it somewhere here, or you know, somewhere, anywhere on my face, and see if it is working. Only then I'm gonna apply it on my face. So whenever you purchase any product, I keep repeating it again and again, please do a patch test, okay? And if you all have seen my previous video, you all might have known that I had tried kojic acid face wash earlier, and I documented my journey back then. If you haven't checked it, please go and check it out now. So the thing is, I'm already using kojic acid face wash so far. You all might have a question that, okay, if you're using kojic acid face wash, how can you use this? My personal recommendation is you can use two face wash, provided you're not mixing it together. So now, without any further delay, let's get started. So I've damped my face, and then I start by taking a few pumps of face wash. And what I've usually noticed is that, you know, we apply the face wash in a circular motion around our cheeks, but we usually avoid the forehead area, and that's where most of the pimples and acne starts forming because of oily scalp, dandruff and everything. So I make sure I start there first, followed by my cheeks and everything, and I usually do it at least for 2 to 3 minutes minimum. That's how much is required. Okay, so today was day one, and after washing my face, my honest review is whenever you use a salicylic acid serum or face wash, you will have a little bit of tingling sensation, which is normal. A bit is normal, which is what I'm feeling right now, a bit of tingling sensation and everything. But the good thing is, unlike other gel-based face wash, this is not making my face tight. I had a similar review for the kojic acid product as well. Whenever you are using a face wash, that face wash is not supposed to make your skin feel very tight and very, you know, extremely dry or something like that. Although the motto of salicylic acid is to dry out your face a little bit because your skin is oily, and because of that oil, the sebum production increases, which leads to acne, pimples and everything, okay? So that's the motto. So this is what I felt. This is how my skin is looking, a bit reddish and not dry at all. Now I'm gonna top it with moisturizer, sunscreen, everything. See you tomorrow.
Today is day two of using salicylic acid face wash, and as you can see, my pimples and acne, well, they're still bloody red. Let's see what today brings for us. One thing that I've noticed is that tingling sensation that I was talking about on day one has slightly reduced. So I'm assuming that with every face wash, it's gonna reduce further. So I think that is definitely a good sign. And yeah, my face is looking slightly red, but I don't think so. I'm gonna worry about that. And yeah, my skin looks very soft and bumpy. Yeah, it definitely looks good.
Hello, today is day 3 of me using salicylic acid face wash to check if it is helpful with the pimples, acne, oily face, etc, etc. 3 days of using this face wash and I feel one change that I've noticed is that my face doesn't feel oily anymore. And one thing which is absolutely normal while using any salicylic acid product is that your face will feel a bit dry and there will be this tiny tingling sensation, a very slight burning sensation, which is normal. If it is too much, stop using the product immediately. Okay, again, I said do a patch test, only then use the product. Not every skin is the same. Now, even my skin is a combination skin, so not all products are effective on my face. It can work for you, it may not work for me, it can work for me, it may not work for you, etc, etc. Okay, so let's see, without any further delay, let's wash our face. I washed my face, pat dry. Oh, let me add my mic, sorry. Because itna, hello, mic testing. I hope it's working. It's working? Yeah, it's working. Because itna sara construction things keep happening na, that without this, I can't function. Okay, so today one thing that I noticed is, which earlier also I noticed, is that tingling sensation which I was talking about has slightly reduced. What I'm trying to see here is if this product helps with the, you know, reducing new acne and pimple production, and you know, if it helps in drying out these breakouts quicker, and if it makes my skin less oily. If these things also happen by day 7, I will definitely continue using this product because I am legit looking for a good face wash. But yeah, let's see. So see you tomorrow. Cha cha. Hello, today is day 6 of using salicylic acid face wash. I know, day 4 and day 5 gayab ho gaya. To be honest, I just forgot to document it. I have used the face wash, but I couldn't document it. Ghar pe bahut log the. But positive improvement is my pimples and acne have dried out. I mean, I don't know how much evident it is in this camera, sorry, in this mobile. But see, this, if I could see day 1, it was pulpy red. It was like red, like making my nose look like what? Rudolph the Red Nose Reindeer. And look at this also. This is my, obviously, my till beauty spot. But if I can see this, okay, it has dried out. Let me just come closer. See. It was like pulpy red, but now it is dried out. Very minor difference, but it is evident, okay? Yaha ka bhi dry out ho chuka hai. And yaha ka bhi. So, okay. So, today is day 6 and tomorrow is day 7. Tomorrow, I will do a comparison from day 1 to day 7. And, you know, probably there should be some difference. As I said, the pimples and acne have dried out. So, definitely there will be some difference. So, chalo, let's wash our face. Choo-choo-choo. Okay, so I washed my face and now I can 100% confirm about that tingling sensation. It's gone. It's completely gone, okay? Like initially, as I said, when I started, I was feeling now it's not there. So I think again, that's a progress. And again, my skin is not feeling dry. You all can see, okay? It is not like very dry and very face doesn't feel tight or something like that. So yeah, today was day 6 of using this product. Tomorrow is the final day, D-Day. So let's see, tomorrow I'll use the product. I'll do a day 1 to day 7 comparison. So make sure you watch the video till the end. And see you tomorrow. Ta-ta! Hello, good morning. Today is day 7 of using salicylic acid face wash. So without me doing further chapat, let's get that going. And then I will come back, do the comparison. Let's go. I don't know, I'm just super duper excited whenever I complete a challenge. Chalo. Okay, so now I have pat dry my face. So let's see what's the difference. I can definitely see the difference. I don't know about you guys. Okay, so this is how my face is looking right now. Left, center, right. No, this was left, this was right. What's wrong with me? Now let's see the video from day one and then let's see what is the difference. Okay, you can clearly see this, my pimple. Okay, this big pimple I had, this big reddish pimple that I had dried out and it's nearly invisible right now. Thoda bahut scars hai, but almost invisible. This, if you all can see, okay, near my beauty spot, you all can clearly see this part. It has completely dried out. Earlier on the first day it was like red everything. Another major improvement is this one, because I didn't think this will reduce, because I think on day 3 or day 2 I had mentioned that, oh, this is so painful, this is so reddish and everything. So this has also dried out, and this you can see there's a scar mark here, but it has dried out. Okay, so my acne and my pimples dried out and it's almost like there's just these scar marks there. So that is a major improvement, at least for me. See, I'm being very honest, okay? Do not expect some miracle in day 7 as, you know, people promise in these marketing videos and everything, okay? Your acne and your pimples disappearing in 7 days, it's not feasible unless you're God's favorite child. But for me, it's a big deal because, as I said earlier, it takes at least 12 to 13 days for my pimple and for my acne to get like to shrink, okay? And then it will start drying out, okay? And salicylic acid, anything, serum, face wash, it does wonders for your face, okay? Like when you start using it, as I said, initially you'll feel that tingling sensation and then it will start drying your face out and then oil production will stop and everything. So it does wonders. So this is looking amazing, okay? I'm not gonna lie, I definitely think that's a progress. So am I gonna use this product? Yes, definitely I'm gonna use this product, okay? So please do consider purchasing a salicylic acid face wash. As I said, there are so many market leaders. You can definitely, you know, do your analysis, do your homework, and whatever works best for your skin, do that. And yeah, I think day 7, all these 7 days, the challenge was great. It was amazing. It made me stick to a routine, which I'm gonna continue. And yes, let me know your thoughts on this video. If you enjoyed this video, do please hit the like button, do comment, share and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. You can also comment below what topics you'll want me to cover next and I'll definitely work on that. So yes, that was it. Hope you all enjoyed the video and yes, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.